It's one of the most popular game shows around the world, and here in Australia, the success of Wheel of Fortune is put down to John Burgess. The beloved Burjo, with the nickname Baby John, hosted Wheel of Fortune for 12 years and has plenty of stories to tell. He sat down with our Craigie Bennett for a look back at his stellar showbiz career.
It's the TV game show favourite seen in over 40 countries around the world. And despite being off air in Australia for 11 years and having had seven different hosts, there is one Wheel of Fortune star who is hands down a fan fave, and that's Burjo.
Thank you very much. Yes, that is the Wheel of Fortune. Some great prizes.
Long before he was a TV game show king, John Burgess was a 10-pin bowling champ until a chance encounter at a bowling alley got him a break in radio.
John Laws had just said, I got a good voice and I should be in radio. So I went up and made myself known to him, taught him a bit of bowling stuff and what have you, and that's how it started. Now, we had a pretty strong bond. But then I got into radio in 1965. Then he dropped me like a cake then. I wasn't a threat, but he thought, you know, well, maybe it's time to part ways, let him do his own thing. Baby love,
my baby love. That auspicious encounter with Lawsy put Burjo on a path to a stellar showbiz career, and it also landed him the nickname of Baby John that still lingers 50 years on.
I was the youngest at the radio station, and I wasn't that young, but everybody else was slightly older, and he used to say, the baby will be on next. And I went from the baby to Baby John. So it's a nickname that I inherited all those years ago and still get it. Thanks for bringing it up. It's a nickname. It's stuck with me. I mean, it sounds as if I'm, you know, patting myself on the back here, but not too many people around Australia, if someone mentions Baby John, wouldn't know who you're talking about.
In 1984 came a phone call that would change John's life forever, an offer to replace Ernie Sigley as the host of Wheel of Fortune.
And now, here's our favourite wheeler and dealer, John Burgess!
Thank you very much. Yes, that is the Wheel of Fortune.
Burjo was teamed with the stunningly beautiful Adriana Xenides, and for 12 years, the two became game show royalty, with Wheel a huge ratings hit.
Yeah, it was a pretty successful program, I have to say. It was the number one rating show at 5:30 across the country. Of course, in those days, there was only one television in the house, Craig, you know, so mum would be getting the dinner, kids would come home from school, and they were forced to sit down and watch it because there was nothing else for them to do. We had well over a million people watching us at 5:30, which other shows would have died for.
You must be too young, Debbie, for this. I remember all the words. Shake,
oh,
rattle and roll.
No.
Bill Haley and the Comets. Oh, dear.
Why do you think people loved you so much as a game show king?
Oh, I don't think it was so much about the game. The show itself was fantastic.
No, other people have done that show and run it into the ground. You provided juggernaut ratings.
Well, I don't know. I've always thought that I don't offend anybody. What you see is what you get with me. You know, I don't sort of make things up. I don't try and sound any different than what I talk normally, like we're just talking here. That's just me, 24/7. People like to see people winning things, you know, and you don't patronise people. You know, everybody gets the same chance at winning the prizes, and you don't mess about with stuff like that. That's always been my outlook.
Despite 12 years of record ratings, Burjo was dumped as host of Wheel, a decision that not only rocked the TV industry, but stunned Burjo.
It was in June 1996, I'll never forget it as long as I live, when I got the phone call, because I was employed by Grundy's, not by the network, at that particular time. And Andrew Brook from Grundy's rang me, and I was going to Sydney to do a charity thing. And we used to play golf together. So I said, oh, we should have a game of golf. He said, yeah, that'd be fine. He said, but by the way, they want to change the host to Wheel of Fortune. Well, I said to my wife, I said, life as we know it has now finished.
The bottom must have fallen out of your world.
Yeah, it did.
Job offers for John immediately flooded in, and he was quickly snapped up by the Nine Network, who put him on a retainer while they found him a show. All the while, Burgess fans were fuming that Channel 7 had axed him as Wheel of Fortune host and replaced him with Tony Barber. The backlash was immediate and extraordinary, and it wasn't long before Channel 7 realised their error and tried to lure Burgess back.
And then in December of 1996, the same year, well, it's really 6 months to the day later, they rang me from Channel 7 and said, we've made a dreadful mistake, and offered him a job back.
Because Tony Barber, with great respect, a game show king, sailor of the century, loved and adored by millions.
Sure.
But there was a mutiny. Viewers didn't want him hosting Wheel of Fortune. They wanted you.
I mean, it's very humbling to think that way. An editor of a newspaper actually wrote to himself in the newspaper and said, please, no more letters about John Burgess. And they printed two double sheets in very tiny print, like the phone book, of all the letters they got from people saying that they'll never watch Wheel of Fortune again. And not because of Tony, I don't think. It was just that we'd built something up to such a level. People don't like change.
For 12 years, John Burgess and Adriana Xenides ruled the airwaves. It was their chemistry and banter that cemented the success of Wheel of Fortune.
You like your new set?
Yes, I do. I love it.
Okay. Adri's been waiting for a new set for such a long time, and here it is.
We worked together for 12 years and never had a blue, Adri and I, which is, I'm sure you would realise.
Doesn't happen in television often, does it?
No, doesn't happen very often at all. Yeah, never had a blue. We got on extremely well.
John and Adriana became lifelong chums, and when the devastating news came through in 2010 that Adriana was in hospital and in a dire state, John and his wife Jan rushed to her side.
She was in a coma when I got there. Leo, my wife, says that when I leant over and said, Adri, Burgess here, she said that she opened her eyes very briefly, but I didn't see it because I was, in tears virtually. Yeah. Because to look at her, I mean, it's hard to recognise her. It was awful.
For all of those years that you worked with her, did you know that underneath that fabulousness and the wonderful smiley faces and her prowess at turning those letters was such a troubled woman?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, she. Adrian would do anything for anybody. I mean, she would. Yeah, in that regard, absolutely fantastic. But she didn't look after herself as well as what she should have.
For 30 years of showbiz highs and lows, there has been a steady constant in John's life, his beloved wife, Jan. In 2014, Jan was diagnosed with breast cancer. 3 years later, she received the devastating news she had liver cancer. The couple are intensely private and have kept the battle relatively secret until now.
It's getting tough now, Craig.
It was in 2017 that Jan and John were told by doctors she had months to live.
We have to do something about this immediately. You've got a cholangiocarcinoma in your liver, and if you don't do anything about it, you won't see your birthday in March. It was the 9th of December.
2017.
Shook me up a bit, I can tell you, not to mention Jan, of course.
How did you cope when that news came through?
Well, it was pretty awful. And so for then, from that point on, virtually became sort of, I'm not there 24/7 anyway, but it knocked her about a lot. And and she's on medication, which a lot of side effects. I mean, she's not the only person. There are millions of women in the world, don't get me wrong, going through all of this. So we're not saying, well, this is awful, should happen to us. But when it happens to you, it puts a different perspective on things, I can assure you. So the last couple of years, it's been pretty tough. Certainly a lot tougher for Jan than it's been for me, but we're getting there.
Beyond the amazing medical technology and those medications that are available now, do you think the love that you two have also is a contributing factor to this miracle of her continuing survival?
Well, they'd like to think so, you know. You'll be probably surprised to hear this, Craig, but I actually do Twitter and Facebook every day. So I said that we had some rather disturbing news about my wife's health, and she has to have a big operation, and it's today. I would ask you, if you wouldn't mind, if you could just send us some love and light. Nearly 50,000 people did. My wife believes, and so do I. I think it had a profound effect on her recovery.
I do too.
Yeah.
Burgio has enjoyed an illustrious career, and the surprises keep coming. John is the face of a new campaign for Smith's Chips.
What's it like to see your face dangling from the ceilings of supermarkets and you're all over the telly now, have been for a couple of weeks? Is it a thrill to be advertising something this with all you've done?
Just to be asked, just to have a crack at participating was, that was amazing to me. So to actually be chosen to do it, I'm, as I said, truly, truly chuffed.
The Smith's Chips promotion has Burgio once again reunited with a wheel, and he said he would love to return to that TV favourite.
I mean, it's on in about 34 countries in the world. It's not on in Australia for some unknown reason. Don't ask me why. I think, here I go again, patting myself on the back. If some enterprising television network thought it was a good idea to bring it back with Burgio mainly, I think it'd be a very big story, and I reckon it would be a bonanza. What's the boss's name again?